we need to invert the following. You see, n plus 1, let's write down the recursion, but this time, let's note that we already have a relation between an and an tilde. So, an plus 1 z is an z plus kn plus 1 z inverse z to the power minus n an z inverse. Let's write that down straight away. And similarly, an plus 1 tilde z is z inverse times z raised to the power minus n an z inverse plus kn plus 1 an z. So what we want to do is to get the an from the an plus 1 now. You see, so we need to invert. Now, that's very easy to do. I just need, let me call this relationship 1 and let me call this relationship 2. All that I need to do is to cut off this term, really, you know. I can try and get rid of the an z inverse term. That's very easy to do. I can just subtract kn plus 1 times this from this. So, all that I need to do is to operate one minus kn plus 1 times 2. And that gives me a very simple and elegant relationship. It says n plus 1 z minus kn plus 1 an plus 1 tilde z is an z minus kn plus 1 squared an z. As simple as that. Now, you see, this is of course very easy to write, 1 minus kn plus 1 squared an z. So, now we have an z in terms of an plus 1. In fact, we know how to construct an plus 1 tilde z from an plus 1 z. We know how to do that by the inductive relation. So, in fact, what this says is that an z is then an plus 1 z minus kn plus 1 z to the power minus n plus 1 an plus 1 z inverse divided by 1 minus kn plus 1 squared. So, we have the most important step completed, the backward step. From an plus 1, you can go one step back. Now, we can think of this as peeling off one stage. You may want to visualize the lattice structure like a piece of cabbage, where you have peel after peel after peel. Each stage is like a peel. So, what we've done is to peel off one layer of that cabbage, and you see the inner layer now. Now, you can peel off. Now, you see, this is recursive. So you know how to go from an plus 1 to an. And the same approach can be used to go from an to an minus 1. And you can keep doing this until you reach a1. And once you reach a1, of course, you're done. Now, in this process, the properties of an would be maintained. Because if you look at it again, here, you see, it is very clear that, see, the whole idea was that we would need to maintain the property that the coefficient of z to the power of 0 is 1 and so on. Now, that would continue to be maintained in this recursion. I leave it to you to verify that.
Right?
But one word of caution. There's only one situation in which we'll have trouble here. And that relates to when this denominator becomes degenerate. So, there is degeneracy when kn plus 1 equal to 0. That means in this lattice recursion, at any stage, if you find that this k turns out to be 1, then you have a degeneracy. You cannot realize it with the lattice structure. I'm sorry. Yes. I meant to say kn plus 1. I meant to say 1 minus kn plus 1 squared is equal to 0. Yeah, that's correct. Kn plus 1, in fact, I would prefer to say kn plus 1 squared is equal to 1. And of course, we are assuming that the coefficients are all real, k's are real. So it could be either plus or minus 1. Right? So plus or minus 1 lattice parameter. Now, this is called, the kn is called the lattice parameter. Let's take note of this term. Kn is called the lattice parameter. So degeneracy results when the lattice parameter takes the value plus or minus 1. And degeneracy means that that system function cannot be realized with the lattice. Now, in fact, it is, of course, an important question why a degeneracy takes place. And why these lattice parameters are so interesting. I mean, this just looks like any other structure. What is so special about this? We will now put down a very important theorem which will explain why this is so important. I shall not prove this theorem, but I shall state it. The lattice parameters indicate the location of the roots of HFIRZ with respect to the unit circle. In the following specific way. The roots of HFIRZ are within the unit circle. That means all of modulus less than unity. Now, not strictly less than unity. If and only if all the lattice parameters corresponding to HFIR are less than 1 in magnitude, That means if the system function h fir z has all its lattice parameters less than 1 in magnitude, you are guaranteed that it has its roots inside the unit circle, and vice versa. If you require that h fir z have all its roots inside the unit circle, then all the lattice parameters must be less than 1 in magnitude. Now, why is this important? In fact, not so much for an fir function. It's important for the denominator in a rational function. That means what we want to do is to exploit this property to study the denominator of a rational system function. And that is the next step that we'd like to take. And that's the reason why, as somebody asked, why are we creating that auxiliary function an tilde? That auxiliary function an tilde is being created to allow us to exploit this property to realize a rational system function in general. So we are actually going to use these k's to realize the denominator, and the numerator would be realized with some other type of coefficients. And then we will get insight into the stability of the rational system function by looking at the k's. Now, what does it mean about the k equal to 1 case, or mod k equal, or k squared equal to 1 case? It means there is trouble. If you find that any of the k's becomes plus minus 1, then you have a problem with the solutions. The if and only if relation. So, you know, if you are trying to look at, so you know what you could, I mean, irrespective of whether you are realizing a rational system function, what this tells you is that if I am given the denominator polynomial in a rational system function, and of course I have told you that in a causal rational system function, you can always write the denominator with a leading one. In a causal, I repeat, in a causal rational system function, you are always in a position to write the denominator with a leading one. The coefficient of z to the power of 0 is equal to 1. Once you do that, take the denominator as it is. Think of it as a system function and realize it with the lattice structure. And then if you want to check whether the system is stable or not, all the solutions must of course lie within the unit circle, and that implies that all the lattice parameters must be strictly less than 1 in magnitude. So it's a very simple test for stability of a rational system function. Let's make a note of that. So this, yes, there's a question. The question is, what happens if the magnitude is greater than 1, or in fact for that matter, what happens if the magnitude is equal to 1? Well, all that we are saying at the moment is that if the magnitude, if all the magnitudes are not less than 1 strictly, you are sure that there is a root either on the unit circle or outside. That's all that we can say at the moment. We are not going further at the moment, right? So there is a one-to-one, I mean, there is stability implies and is implied by, or you know, what I mean is, if you want to check that all the roots of a polynomial in Z inverse are within the unit circle, then it is necessary and sufficient that all the corresponding lattice parameters be less than 1 in magnitude. If that condition is violated, you are sure that there is a violation also of the roots being inside the unit circle. Now, in what way, we don't know. Whether the roots are on the unit circle or the roots are also outside, that we are not going into at the moment. In fact, we haven't even proved this. This proof is a little involved. Time permitting, we'll see if we can give a small proof. I would also like to offer it to you as a challenge, but it's a rather difficult challenge. Well, actually, I can tell you, if some of you are really interested in taking up the challenge and trying to prove this, the central idea in the challenge is to look at what happens when you create an all-pass-like function as you have here. You know, the relation between an and an tilde and the recursive relation between an and an plus 1 is at the heart of this proof. You know, anyway, I don't want to spend too much of time on that. Safe to say that the proof is a little involved, and we shall take it up if time permits, right? But we must know the consequences. The theorem should be understood very. The theorem is not too difficult to understand. It says that necessity and sufficiency, it states the necessity and sufficiency of all the lattice parameters being less than 1 in magnitude for all the roots of that polynomial to be inside the unit circle. Now, why is this useful? That's what we are going to do next. What we are going to do next is to assume then that we have a rational causal system function as follows. As usual, it is of the form summation m going from 0 to capital M, bm z raised to the power minus m divided by 1 plus or minus whatever you like, doesn't matter, l equal to 1 to n al z raised to the power minus l. We want to realize with a lattice. Obviously, you can't do it as it is. So far, our lattice only allows us to realize FIR system functions. And the real use of the lattice is in studying this. So what we need to do is to make a little change in the equations or the recursive equations of the lattice. We could go back. Let's go back and look at those recursions once again. So, in fact, maybe we don't even need to do that. Let's write them right from fundamentals. So, we won't even write the system functions now. We'll write the sequences right from the beginning. We'll go back to the very first pair of equations that we wrote in terms of sequences on the lattice. So, we had En plus 1 z is Enz plus Kn plus 1 Z inverse En tilde Z. And En plus 1 tilde Z is Z inverse Enz, En tilde Z, I'm sorry, plus Kn plus 1, yeah, Enz. Now, all that we do is to make a little rearrangement of this. So, we just rearrange it and rewrite this as Enz is En plus 1z minus Kn plus 1 z inverse En tilde z. It's an interesting situation that we have here. We have En plus 1 tilde written in terms of En tilde and En. And we have En again written in terms of En plus 1 and En tilde. So let's write down the structure that this implies. Now please note that we have not changed the basic equations. The basic equations are the same. So, therefore, the basic relationships remain the same. The basic relationships don't change. But the structure changes, and the structure would look like this. You see, what we'll do is we'll now draw the structure the other way. So, we'll move this way from E0 to En. Or En tilde. So we assume that somewhere here you have an E0 and E0 tilde and you're moving this way. So we write one stage. So we have En tilde here, please, not En. And of course, En there. And go back to the equation. You have an En tilde z multiplied by z inverse. So there we are. Now, what does this equation say? This equation says z inverse times em tilde needs to be multiplied by minus km plus 1 and added to en plus 1. In fact, let us make this en plus 1 here for convenience. Oh, well, I am sorry. I think this is all right. Right? So, you need to multiply this by km plus 1, rather minus km plus 1. Now, what about this equation here? En plus 1 tilde z. So, you know, you have an, let's keep forming the structure. So, you know, it's a little complicated. You have en plus 1 tilde being formed here. En plus 1 tilde is formed with a z inverse en tilde z and kn plus 1 times en z. So, you need a kn from here and this as it is, isn't it? You see, en plus 1 tilde z is z inverse en tilde z. Z inverse en tilde z is essentially this plus kn plus 1 en z. So, you need a kn plus 1 to come from there. Let me write it like this. Maybe I, you know, to map, let's remove this branch for the moment. Let's take this later. Let's draw only one pair of branches. It will make it look much neater. You have en tilde. You have a z inverse. We realize this equation first. So, we add this to this multiplied by kn plus 1. So, what we have done is to realize this equation here. Now, you see the second equation is en plus 1 minus kn plus 1 times z inverse en tilde. You see, so that is a funny situation to be in. You have an en plus 1 here. You need to take en plus 1 and subtract from it kn plus 1 times z inverse, z inverse times en tilde. Right? So, you need to realize this equation in the second branch. Now, how would you get that? You would need to take en plus 1 as it is and subtract from it kn plus 1 times z inverse en tilde. Now, you are getting z inverse en tilde here. Multiply that by minus kn plus 1 and add it to en plus 1. And this is what should give us en. So, in fact, now we have a problem. You see, now this is the kind of structure that we expect, right? We need to see more of this. We'll take this up again in the next lecture. We'll sort of clean up the structure a little more. So we'll have to do a little bit of shifting here. We'll have to rearrange the structure to realize this set of equations. But the philosophy is the following. The equations are the same, the relationships are the same, but now we are reinterpreting the equations to give us an IR system function, rational system function. We need to spend more time on this, and therefore, we'll continue this in the next lecture by repeating some steps. Thank you.